In the usual bubble sort algorithm, each pass goes left to right, but in the right to left bubble sort algorithm, it goes the other way. First, I'm going to take the code I wrote in my bubble sort video and modify it so it goes right to left. Then I'll go through it step by step to show how it manages to sort things, even though it looks like it's going backwards. Then I'll show what happens when the input's already sorted, almost sorted, or reversed. This is the code I wrote in my bubble sort video. The first thing I'm going to do is make it so you can specify part of the array to sort. Say you wanted to sort the subarray from element 20 to element 100 or something like that. I'm going to do it by refactoring, which means I'm going to make changes to the code that affect the way it's written, but not the result. So at the end of it, I'll still have the same bubble sort as before, but the code will be a bit easier to work with. I'm going to create a variable called passLeft to represent the left-hand side of the range that we're going to sort. And right now we're sorting the whole array, so we're starting at zero. Now these zeros here actually represent the left-hand side of the range we're sorting. So I'm going to replace these with passLeft. And I can replace a zero with a variable that happens to always be zero without changing the meaning. And then I'm going to create a variable called passRight to represent the right-hand side of the range that we're sorting, which if we're sorting the whole list is going to be equal to the length of result. Now as it happens, passesLeft was already serving this purpose in the program we've already got. So I'm just going to rename passesLeft to passRight. And I can rename a variable without changing the meaning of the program. I'm also going to swap these over just because it's confusing to have left on the right and right on the left. And I can swap those over again without changing the meaning of the program. I'm going to refactor one more thing. I'm going to change this repeat for loop into a repeat until loop. By the way, repeat until means the same as repeat while not, if you're more familiar with while loops. Now I've got this passLeft and passRight variable. You can actually use them to specify a part of the list you want to sort. So for example, if I put passLeft as 20 and passRight as 100, then what happens is it'll only sort that subrange within the array. Anyway, now I've done that refactoring, it's going to be much easier for me to take the bubble sort algorithm and flip it around to turn it into the right to left bubble sort algorithm. What I'm going to do is replace this passLeft with passRight, and then I'm going to swap these two expressions. This represents where we're starting and this represents where we're finishing the loop. So we put the passRight minus one here and the passLeft up here. And then I need to reverse the direction of this loop by putting I minus equal one here instead of the I plus equal one here. And then this passRight needs to be passLeft. And that gives you the right to left bubble sort algorithm. Now I'll step through it to show you how it works. So if I run through it quite quickly, you can see what happens is that instead of the largest element bubbling up to the top, on each pass, the smallest element sinks down to the bottom. So first the one, then the two, then the 3, then the 4. And then, because we've got our optimizations, it figures out that it's already sorted. So the question then is, how does a pass cause the smallest element to sink down to the bottom? We'll start by looking at the two elements on the right, in this case the 3 and the 2, and if they're in the wrong order, we'll swap them. Another way of saying that is if the smallest one is on the right, then we need to swap them. If the smallest one is already on the left, then we don't need to swap them. But in this case, we need to swap them. But either way, the smallest of the two ends up on the left. Then, when we move on to the next iteration, that one on the left that was the smallest of the two becomes the one on the right of the two that we're looking at. So the 2 was the smallest, so we're now looking at the 8 and the 2, and then we do the same thing. We do a test to see which is larger and make sure that the smaller one ends up on the left. So at each iteration, the smaller one ends up on the left. And that smaller number is in fact the smallest one we've seen so far. So it is actually the smallest one in the entire pass. So here we're comparing the 2, which has been the smallest one we've seen so far, but now we've met a 1, and the 1 is even smaller than that. So we're not going to swap here, we're just going to move on, and now the 1 is the smallest seen so far, which then keeps getting moved down until it makes its way to the bottom. And if you keep doing passes that bring the next smallest element down to the bottom, you eventually get a sorted array. Alright, let's take a look at what happens to an array that's already sorted. It just takes one scan through the array, right to left, because this is the right to left bubble sort algorithm, and then figures out that it's done. So that's the best possible case. Now let's take a look at almost sorted. It's using the optimizations I went over in the bubble sort video to skip over passes. So it only takes about 16 passes to sort 128 items, rather than the maximum of 128 or the minimum of 1. Now I'm going to take a look at a shuffled list, but each step is going to be a whole pass. So each pass, the smallest element goes to the bottom. So whereas in bubble sort, the large elements move to the top, in right to left bubble sort, the small elements move to the bottom. In normal bubble sort, the large elements move quickly to the right, and the small elements move one step to the left per pass. With the right to left bubble sort algorithm, the small elements move quickly to the left, and the large elements move to the right one step per pass. By the way, if you like my explanation of the right to left bubble sort algorithm, you know what to do. Now let's see what happens if we sort an array that's reversed. I said in my bubble sort video that the reason the reverse case was slow for bubble sort was because the smallest element was all the way on the right and it could only move one step to the left per pass, which means you had to go through all of the passes. With right to left bubble sort, you might imagine that the small element can move faster, which is true. Unfortunately, the largest element is all the way on the left, and in right to left bubble sort, you can only move the large elements one step to the right per pass. So ultimately, it still requires that you go through every pass, and so the reverse case is still a worst case, even for the right to left bubble sort algorithm. If you alternate between passes of left to right bubble sort and right to left bubble sort, you get bidirectional bubble sort, which is better known as cocktail sort. And if you want to see that, you should check out my cocktail sort video, which you can also find on a playlist with all of my other sorting algorithms videos.